香港中文大學第94屆大會頒授博士、碩士及學士學位典禮現在開始。The 94th Congregation for the Presentation of Doctoral, Master's and Bachelor's Degrees of the Chinese University of Hong Kong will now commence. 請起立, please rise. 奏國歌，請保持肅立並把帽子脫下。Please remain standing and take off your caps for the national anthem.
I declare this congregation open.
请就座, please be seated. Professor Rocky Tuan, the Vice-Chancellor, will now address the congregation.
Council Chairman, distinguished guests, dear graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome. It gives me great honor to address you on this important day for class 2024. Probably one of the most pivotal moments in the lives of all of you who are graduating today. As it celebrates years of hard work and commitment to self-realization. In fact, this ceremony is often known as commencement ceremony, for it marks the beginning of a new journey for you. A few days ago, Typhoon Taraji struck Hong Kong, forcing the university to suspend the scheduled congregation to ensure the safety of all members and guests. This sudden change certainly reminded us that life is unpredictable and challenges and obstacles are inevitable. I am truly grateful for the exceptional professionalism and hard work of my colleagues in making all the necessary arrangements to allow graduates and their families and friends to share this wonderful moment together today. I also want to express my appreciation for the understanding and cooperation of all the graduates and guests. Today, I stand before you with great pride, but also with a profound sense of nostalgia, as I am delivering my final speech at the congregation as the Vice-Chancellor and President of the Chinese University of Hong Kong. I am indeed privileged, and it has given me much joy and professional satisfaction to serve this esteemed institution over the past 7 years, to witness your transformation and to see the university's noble mission, which is to combine tradition with modernity and to bring together China and the West, shine brightly on both the national and global stages. At this emotional moment, I would like to share some thoughts that I hope will prepare and lead you through the gateway to the future. Graduation is not only a time for retrospection, when you commemorate 4 years and sometimes more years of hard work and accomplishment at the university, but it is also a time for introspection, to think deeply about your thoughts, attitudes, and behavior, and how they will guide you in making decisions about career, interpersonal relationships, well-being, and many other aspects of life. While life is like a voyage where challenges and setbacks are inevitable, I urge all of you to carry with you the following five V's. V, as you know, is of course also the Roman numeral for five, so it's very easy. Five and V is the same, which highlight the qualities I believe you have cultivated at CUHK that will serve you well as you prepare to face life's challenges and complexities. The first V, vigor, wood like, jing like, huoli, jing li. No matter what your future holds, you will soon realize that life does not get easier as you grow older. Trust me, I know. You need to get stronger in the face of adversity in order to overcome every obstacle that comes your way with vigor, wood like jing like, which refers not only to physical energy to bounce back, but also the mental and emotional resilience to handle tough times, and the determination to hang on to your dreams and keep going. Now, every one of us in Hong Kong celebrated a summer season of triumphs and breakthroughs by our city's delegation at the Paris Olympics and Paralympics. And we were very proud to see members of the CUHK community compete and shine in the games too. Our Juris Doctor student Vivian Kong claimed the landmark Olympic gold medal in women's épée fencing. Our student athlete and para badminton player Chuman Kai and CUHK's honorary fellow master's alumna and veteran fencer, Allison Yu Chui-yi, impressed us with their exceptional display of willpower throughout the games. Full of vim and vigor, these individuals are shining examples who have shown us how embracing challenges with courage and resolve can propel us forward. The second V, virtue. 傳承美德. 第二個V 是 virtue, 即是品德和美德, 傳承美德. 我們的校訓,博文若禮, 是代表著中大教育的核心價值。 我們希望同學能夠虛心學習, 遵守禮儀, 提升自我的修養和德行, 成為能夠造福對社會都有益的人。 我們現時是身處於人工智能, 日益普及的世界, 自然經常會面對各種兩難的局面, 和困惑的時刻, 甚至有時會考驗我們對信念, 和個人操守的堅持。 中大前校長金耀基教授在闡述大學之道的時候提到, 科技對於現代文明的建構之為重要, 但是文明的未來呢, 不單需要追求真, 亦都要有善和美。 各位同學, 我希望你們好好運用在中大學到的慎思明辨的能力, 了解事物的邏輯, 衡量多方面的因素, 在面對人生的各種抉擇的時候, 切記要以高尚的道德價值為指標, 因為你們所作出的每一個決定和行為, 都會對世界帶來關鍵性的影響。 The third V, venture, 敢於創新, 敢於創新。 第三個V是Venture。 從今日起, 你們將會踏入充滿未知的人生的新階段。 社會上的競爭日趨激烈, 發展日新月異。 你們需要好好利用創新的思維, 以適應瞬息萬變的環境, 才能夠脫穎而出。 去年12月, 中大痛失了湯曉歐教授。 湯教授,我的好友, 是信息工程學系的老師, 亦是全球人工智能領域其中一位最具影響力的科學家。 湯教授四分一個世紀以來, 與中大結下不解之緣。 他創立的商湯科技, 是中大孕育的第一間獨角獸公司。 湯教授在他的企業裏面一直倡導黑羊文化, 鼓勵員工要做一個不一樣的羊, 一隻黑色的羊, 敢於不同, 敢於創新。 他深信人工智能就是要創造現在還未有出現的東西。 這份敢於創新, 跳出固有思維的勇氣, 就是要大家可以多多學習, 能夠為你開闢與眾不同。 The fourth V, vision, 開拓視野, 開拓視野。 第四個V是vision。 對中大而言, 推動多元共融, 絕對不是空口說白話, 而是全體大學成員 共同守護的價值。 我們尊重每個人的獨特性, 及能力, 共同建構一個充滿活力的學習環境, 讓每個人都能夠發揮所長, 作長, 成長。 我們深信, 當每位成員都能貢獻一己之力, 整個團隊便能成就更加偉大的成果。 中大前校長, 諾貝爾物理學得主, 有光纤之父的资深的高坤教授对成就伟大有深刻的体会他说生命中最伟大的成就就是能做出对世界有正面影响的事情中大一直非常强调同学们要建立对社会的责任感我们提供不同的学习体验机会 就是希望你们通过实际的行动感受到可以切实的为社会带来正面的改变毕业后我希望你们继续积极融入社群拥抱多元不要停止参与义务的工作继续以你们的专业知识在各行各业推动可持续发展 请不要忘记,重大的改变往往是从小小的行动开始累积而成。 The fifth V, vibrancy, 绽放活力, 绽放活力, 代表生命的活力。 各位同学,离开校园之后, 你们的人生应该是更加充满活力更加多姿多彩你们的身心健康应当放在首位而且记得珍惜你们在中大遇到的每一个人跟他们保持紧密的联系不要忘记你的家人师长和朋友曾经给予的支持与鼓励成就了今天的你他们的爱 和关怀将继续帮助你面对生活中的风风雨雨好像现在的风风雨雨启发你们成为更好的人还有你们毕业后呢就会很快成为中大校友无论日后你身处本港内地或是海外希望你们与母校保持联系成为中大的大使 连接中大在全球强大的校友网络，携手一起缔造更美好的世界。Let me now say a few words of congratulations to our honorary graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, as we have come together to celebrate the achievements of students who have completed their doctoral, master, or bachelor's program at CUHK, we are also here to acknowledge four outstanding individuals who were conferred honorary graduates by the university yesterday. Well, actually not yesterday, now it's Wednesday. I didn't correct that word in my speech because we got delayed. For their distinguished contributions in their own professional field, please join me in giving a round of applause. To the following individuals, Professor Victor Joseph Zhao, Doctor of Science, honoris causa, Professor Nancy Jane Rothwell, Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, Dr. Carlson Tong Ka-shing, Doctor of Social Science, honoris causa, and Dr. Deng Xiaohua, more popularly known through her writings as Chan Xue, Doctor of Literature, honoris causa. Please accept our heartfelt congratulations on their receiving their well-deserved honor. The CHK community is extremely delighted to forge stronger bonds with our distinguished honorary alumni. So, I'm going to say my conclusion now. I mentioned earlier that this is the last time I speak at the congregation as the Vice-Chancellor and President of CUHK. In preparing for this, and as I reminisce about the more than 2,500 days I have spent at the university, my heart swells with great pride and thankfulness. I am proud of the spirit of excellence that defines the CUHK community and am deeply grateful for the dedication of all university members, empowering us to scale new heights. In fact, I am sure you are interested to know that this year, the Chinese University of Hong Kong has secured its historically highest international ranking in three major global university rankings, and also in Asia university rankings, placing CUHK securely as a top 50 university of the entire world, not to mention also the distinctions we have received in many different subjects. This is a truly impressive testimony to the outstanding achievements of the CUHK community. CUHK has also successfully launched and established significant and strategic research and academic collaborations with many outstanding mainland and international partners. Therefore, playing a critical role as a superconductor and fulfilling an important part of the mission that I mentioned earlier, to bring together China and the West, or more properly, the world. Again, I would like to express my deep gratitude to all members of the CUHK community who have made these accomplishments possible. So, dear graduates, as you are about to begin a new journey of personal growth, let the knowledge you have acquired and the memories we have shared at CUHK be your guiding lights. Forge your path forward towards excellence with purpose and responsibility, and shape a bright future for our community, our country, and the world. Now, to really conclude, let me borrow the beautiful words of the Irish and share this prayer with all of you. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the warm rays of sun fall upon your home, and may the land of a friend always be near. May green be the grass you walk on. May blue be the skies above you. May pure be the joys that surround you. And may true be the hearts that love you. Finally, may you spread your wings and soar high. Thank you very much.
The Acting Dean of the Graduate School will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Doctor and Master of Philosophy.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Doctor of Medicine.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to the degree of Doctor of Medicine.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Doctor of Education, Doctor of Nursing, and Doctor of Psychology.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
And Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Master of Philosophy.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to the degree of Master of Philosophy.
The Acting Dean of Arts will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Master and Bachelor from Faculty of Arts.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degrees of Master of Arts, Master of Divinity, Master of Fine Arts, and Master of Music.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their degree of Bachelor of Arts.
The Acting Dean of Business Administration will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Master and Bachelor from Faculty of Business Administration.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Master of Accountancy, Master of Business Administration, Master of Professional Accountancy, and Master of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Bachelor of Science and Bachelor of Business Administration.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
The Dean of Education will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Master and Bachelor from Faculty of Education.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degrees of Master of Arts, Master of Education, and Master of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Education, and Bachelor of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
The Dean of Engineering will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Master and Bachelor from Faculty of Engineering.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Master of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to the degree of Master of Science.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degrees of Bachelor of Engineering and Bachelor of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
The Dean of Law will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Jewish Doctor, Master, and Bachelor from Faculty of Law.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degrees of Juris Doctor and the Master of Laws.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Bachelor of Laws.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to the degree of Bachelor of Laws.
The Dean of Medicine will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Master and Bachelor from Faculty of Medicine.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Master of Chinese Medicine, Master of Clinical Pharmacy, Master of Nursing, Master of Nursing Science, Master of Public Health, and Master of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Bachelor of Chinese Medicine, Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery, Bachelor of Nursing, Bachelor of Pharmacy, and Bachelor of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
The Dean of Science will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Master and Bachelor from Faculty of Science.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduate for the degree of Master of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to the degree of Master of Science.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduate for the degree of a Bachelor of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to the degree of Bachelor of Science.
The Dean of Social Science will request the Council Chairman to present graduates for the degrees of Master and Bachelor from Faculty of Social Science.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degrees of Master of Architecture, Master of Arts, Master of Science, Master of Social Science, and Master of Social Work.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present graduates for the degree of Bachelor of Social Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to the degree of Bachelor of Social Science.
The Provost will now address the graduates.
Graduates of doctoral, master's, and bachelor's degrees of the Chinese University of Hong Kong, please rise. Now, please put on your academic cap and move the tassel from right to left. You have all done exceptionally well. And you have all done us proud. As you embark on new journeys with confidence and vigor and scale new heights, always remember that CUHK is your intellectual home. It will always remain your home away from home. Congratulations And may I please invite all guests present to join me in applauding our graduates in recognition of their significant achievements. Congratulations.
The Pro Vice-Chancellor Education will request the Council Chairman to present the list of graduates for the degrees of Doctoral, Master and Bachelor.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present the list of graduates from the Chinese University of Hong Kong, Shenzhen for the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Philosophy, Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, Master of Science, and Master of Social Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Mr. Chairman, I request you to present the list of graduates from the Chinese University of Hong Kong, Shenzhen, for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Engineering, and Bachelor of Science.
In accordance with the Senate's resolution, I hereby present these graduates to their respective degrees.
Dr. Tong Ka-shing, Carlson, will now deliver an address.
Council Chairman, Professor Chai, Vice-Chancellor, Professor Tuan, graduates, distinguished guests, faculties, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. First of all, let me say a congratulations and well done to all the graduates today, because you should be very, very proud of yourself, and so will your family be for all of you. I would also like to express my thanks and appreciation to Chinese University of Hong Kong for the conferment upon me of the honorary degree earlier this week. It is my privilege and honor to join the CUHK family. It is a true honor for me to stand before you today as we recognize your hard work and achievements. Professor Tran earlier gave a very inspirational speech and should take his advice with you on the five D's. I will bear that in mind myself as well. As he said, sadly, it will be his last congregation speech today. As a former chairman of the University Grant Committee myself, I would like to thank Professor Tran for all his contribution to Hong Kong higher education sector. Now, as I share some thoughts with you, I want to think about your journey ahead. In addition to what Professor Tran has said, I'd like to give you three further pieces of advice that I hope will inspire you as you step into a world beyond these walls. I'm afraid you'll be going away from this graduation with lots and lots of advice, and I hope you will try to pick the ones that you think are most important. Now, the first one I want to say is to talk about lifelong learning. Let's start by taking a trip down memory lane to the beginning of my own career. Now, I think I must be the only person here that I don't hold a university degree. I never went to university because when I started, I didn't get enough grades when I graduated to attend university at all. But I was curious, apart from it, to put it another way, I was nosy. Always liked to have an answer for everything. I took a job in an office right after high school, and I was fascinated by the auditors around me. I asked questions, more questions, soaked up knowledge, and pursued every opportunity to learn, and take every opportunity that was offered to me. Eventually, I found myself at KPMG and managed to rise up the ranks and eventually became KPMG China and Asia Pacific Chairman. Here's what I learned. Education doesn't stop at graduation. This is your beginning. It's a lifelong journey. You will never reach a point where you know everything. So my first piece of advice is to cultivate that love for learning. Keep asking questions, seek out new knowledge, and embrace the process of growth at every stage of your career. Next, let's talk about integrity. During my time as Chairman of the Securities and Futures Commission, I saw firsthand the delicate balance between promoting the market and ensuring its quality. We always chose quality because integrity is the bedrock of trust. Remember, without integrity, there's no foundation for success. Although, as you know, recently I've changed my role and now become the chairman of Hong Kong Stock Exchange, my belief has not changed. A quality market is still the bedrock of Hong Kong Exchange and for Hong Kong as an international financial center. Hong Kong is well recognized as a leading international financial center and has been ranked third globally and first in Asia Pacific by the Global Financial Center Index 36 report. Because we are trusted by investors here in mainland China and around the world, because we understand that without quality, without integrity, there will be no market left to promote. So my second piece of advice is this: no matter where you go, or what you do, stand firm in your values. When the pressure mounts, hold your ground even stronger. Your integrity will define you in the impact you can make. Finally, I want to touch on collaboration. As chairman of the Hong Kong Stock Exchange, I'm constantly reminded that we live in an increasingly complex world. Geopolitical tensions, rapid technological changes, these present challenges and uncertainty, but also incredible opportunities. The key to navigating this landscape is collaboration. So my third piece of advice, embrace collaboration. Connect with people across industries, across borders and cultures. Your ability to work together with others will shape the future and drive positive change. Young people like you, with collaborative and global mindsets, you will steer us through a world in transition. You will solve the challenges that we face as a global community, and you will create greater prosperity for us all. So as I wrap up, I want to leave you with this thought. If someone like me, without a degree, can carve out a path, just imagine the limitless possibilities that await you, armed with your hard-earned degrees. So, as you step out into the world, keep learning, uphold your integrity, and foster collaboration. Be bold, take risks, and don't shy away from challenges. Let's create a brighter future together. Go out there and make your mark. Your time is now. Congratulations to each and every one of you, and for letting me be part of this special day. Finally, my congratulations and appreciation to fantastic work done by CUHK to Hong Kong higher education sector over all these years and being one of the top universities globally and regionally. I wish CUHK continued success with its invaluable contribution to the development of Hong Kong and the development of Hong Kong as a leading education hub in the region. Thank you.
Mr. Chen Kam Kwan Max, representative of the postgraduates, will now address the congregation.
主席、校長、各位老師、各位同學，大家好。我是來自病理解剖及細胞學系的畢業生陳錦坤。今日我們終於迎來了屬於自己的高光一刻——畢業典禮。首先，恭喜大家，我們終於做到了，我們終於順利畢業了。在開始之前，我想說，我們真是一班非常幸運的人，我們有幸進入了這所非常優秀的大學，得到一流的教育和資源，有一班非常敬業的老師和志同道合的同學，更加有幸在這段旅程中收穫了無數珍貴的記憶和經驗。今天我們可以站在這裡迎接人生的下一個階段，所以我僅代表全體畢業生向各位致以最深切的謝意。回顧這四年的博士生活，我想我們都可以寫出一本本厚厚的小說，每一版都充滿挑戰、堅持、歡笑和淚水。還記得剛剛入實驗室那一天，我們都懷抱著無限的好奇心和雄心壯志，彷彿世界上沒有任何難題是我們解決不到。當然這個幻想直到我們遇到第一個實驗失敗就已經破滅了了。但是正正因為這些失敗和困難，令我們更加堅強、更加聰明。還記不記得那個通宵捱夜做實驗的日子呢？還有那個為了趕論文而廢寝忘餐的時刻。其實在這些情況下，我們慢慢學識了如何在壓力中保持冷靜，如何在挫折中找到解決問題的方案。更加重要的是，我們學識如何和人合作，在合作裡面實現了共同的目標。我的研究領域是癌症免疫治療，每當我見到病人痛苦無助的樣子，其實我都非常心痛，心痛他們為何要經歷這些事情。因此我就有更加好的動力去做好自己的研究，雖然可能是微不足道，但正如我的導師鄧銘權教授所說，為癌症尋求完美的靈丹妙藥其實是一項非常艱巨的任務。不過只要我們下定決心，任何問題其實都不是沒有辦法攻克的。最重要的是可以為病人帶來希望。這句說話一直不斷激勵我向前行，亦都不會放棄任何一個可以為病人帶來希望的機會。在這裡我想特別多謝我的導師鄧銘權教授，非常感謝他在這四年裡面給我的指導和支持，不單止教我專業的知識和技能，還教識我如何在科研裡面保持創新和嚴謹。他的鼓勵和信任亦都令我不斷成長，我相信在座的同學的老師都是一樣的。在這四年裡面，我們不單止掌握了專業的技能和知識，還學識了如何面對生活裡面的不確定性因素。其實生活上的挫折和困難就好像每一個實驗一樣，都有可能會失敗，但是每一個失敗其實都是我們通往成功的踏腳石。同樣地，每一個挑戰都會令我們有更加好的成長。現在我們即將離開這片非常熟悉的校園，走向各自精彩的人生。無論你是選擇繼續升學、進入公司，還是投入社會公益，請記住我們所擁有的知識和技能是為了服務社會、造福人類。請堅持自己的理想和目標，不要被暫時的困難嚇到。真的不好意思說句，我們是這個時代的精英，我們有能力亦都有責任創造更加美好的未來。最後我想引用高坤教授的一句說話來結束今天的演講。他說過，年輕人總會有自己的夢想，但最重要的是你要清楚理解自己在做什麼，同時為什麼你覺得這件事 是可行和可為的。 多謝大家, 請我們自己鼓掌, 祝大家前程感受。
Ms. Lam Kung Yu Christie, representative of the undergraduates, will now address the congregation.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, Vice-Chancellor, faculty members, esteemed guests, and the class of 2024. I am Christy Lam, a graduate from the Faculty of Law at New Asia College. Today, I'm very honored to address you all on this special and important occasion. First of all, a big congratulations to all of us, because we have finally made it to this day. Indeed, our path to this moment has never been without its challenges. Yet we still managed to overcome numerous obstacles like COVID-19 and Typhoon number 8. Looking back, it feels just like yesterday that we embarked on this journey as eager freshmen. Our faces illuminated by the glow of computer screens as we delve headfirst into the world of online classes on Zoom. I believe all of you still remember the days where we had muted microphones, frozen screens, accompanied by the struggle of finding the perfect virtual background and our endless battle with unstable internet connection. And we're still having orientation camps replaced by orientation cameras and taking exams through a lockdown browser, worrying that our computer would break down any time. Now fast forward to 2 years later, when we were finally back on campus. The transition from Zoom squares to real-life faces was nothing short of exhilarating. Suddenly, the classmates we had only known through screens became tangible, 3D, distinct individuals with unique characteristics. And we were trying to match their familiar faces and voices with the screens we have seen online. Yet, adjusting to a different mode of learning was also a challenge. I remember running all the way from Chongqi College up to Li Shaoqi Building in just 5 minutes after my music class, and even carrying a heavy cello on my back, because I packed the two lessons in my timetable together, having totally forgotten about the physical limitations outside of online classroom. And after we have overcome all these challenges, it finally comes to our graduation day. But then, again, we're met with an unexpected challenge, and this time, Typhoon number 8. And this puts all of us into serious doubts again of whether we're really the most unfortunate class ever. But as always, and luckily, every cloud has a silver lining. And despite all the challenges and missed opportunities that the past have brought us, we stand here today as a testament to our resilience and determination. We're also really thankful for the people who have come to support us today and the people who have supported us through this academic journey. At this point, I would like to take a moment and extend my deepest gratitude on behalf of the graduating class to our professors, the university, our families, and classmates. To our professors and teachers who have endured more than just our last minute submissions and endless questions, your dedication to our education and passion for your respective fields have inspired us to reach new heights and explore the depth of intellectual curiosity. We are forever grateful for your mentorship and guidance. To the university and faculty, you have shaped us into who we are today, providing us with unique and diverse learning experiences to broaden our horizons. Ranging from different events on campus and high table dinners, to competitions and exchange programs internationally. To our parents and families who have supported our education for nearly two decades, your unwavering belief in us and your endless supply of motivation have been the bedrock upon which we have built our dreams and aspirations. To our classmates and friends, thank you for standing by our side through the highs and lows of our academic journey. As we are graduating today, wearing our graduation gowns, saying goodbye, we couldn't help it but already feel nostalgic more than ever, thinking of every amazing things we have experienced together over the years. From studying hard and sleeping in the university library, staring at the Tianwen Tai clock during course registration, pulling all-nighters before a competition deadline, recording lectures for one another when one of us cannot attend class, organizing orientation camps, and tricking freshmen to apply for a CUHK bus card. Try out all the restaurants on campus, and even writing a love story based on a famous five-layer toast for homework submission. Those are the memories we would always cherish. And there isn't even one thing I would like to change about it. But today, we have to bid farewell to all the wonderful people we have met in CUHK. Today is the turning point where we have to embark on a new chapter of our lives. Stepping out into the real world beyond these university walls may seem intimidating, but this is how we grow from timid freshmen who got lost in a CUHK campus to confident graduates ready to give back to the community. Let us find strength in face of adversities. Let us find light amidst the uncertainties, because every challenge is an opportunity. The obstacles are there for a reason, not to keep us out from achieving our goals, but a chance to show how badly we want something. So do not be afraid to take up a challenge, because you need a bit of insanity to do great things. Do not be afraid to chase your dreams, because they are not dreams if they don't scare you. Let us carry the lessons we have learned here and remember the power of resilience, the value of community, and the importance of never giving up. And finally, congratulations again to the class of 2024. May our futures be filled with endless possibilities. And may each and every one of us unleash our unique potentials in every way possible. Thank you, and I wish you all the very, very best.
I declare this congregation closed.
请起立, please rise.